But you know, like talking about the government often say that they have launched many schemes regarding education of children. For example, let's talk about Girl Child. There's this scheme which is known as Beti Padhao, Teach the Girl Child. So do you think that has like brought any changes in the society?
Yeah, actually, even times they have Teach for India, Teach India, several. These are all being done, but whether if you take the statistics, whether these trafficked children are being given proper education, no. You won't get, but who are they like teaching now? They are targeting the poor people, not this kind of a rehabilitation for the trafficked children.
Okay.
So there should be a goal or an agenda to rescue. And they should get a proper education, and education will only can save this child and their save their future. Otherwise, they'll be in the wrong hands, and obviously they'll be doing some untoward incident.
Sir, you were talking about the control measures. Do you think the police and NGO are doing enough to safeguard these children and their interests?
I told earlier, like the police are very ignorant to handle these cases.
Okay.
And in spite, there are several aspects to, as per the IPC and CRPC, police can rescue children and they can do a lot for the children, but they are not doing it because they have their own priority to work. They have several agendas than rescuing these children and giving proper education or something like that. So there, police and NGOs has enormous powers, they can do, but still they are not willing to do it because of they are actually neglecting this section of people, and that is the reason these people are now falling into wrong hands. And
ma'am, what's your take on this, ma'am?
Well, I do believe there's some sort of work that's happening, and as far as India is concerned, there's always a policy in place, there's always, you know, safeguards. And there are very strong safeguards with regard to trafficking, especially with regard to trafficking of children. And there's also other measures like the 1098, the number which children can call. We've met a lot of children who have been rescued by calling that number, which is a toll-free number, and when they are in distress. So these kind of you know, initiatives which publicize and give children an opportunity to come out of wherever they are stuck, that's one way of looking at it. The other is that, you know, we need to work at different levels. One is the policy level, where we look at organizations such as UNICEF, which did extensive studies on the juvenile homes as well as children's homes. What are the safeguards and standards? We heard you know, just now about how, what happens to these children once they are rescued and put into a home. What is the standard of care they receive? What's the aftercare? So at the policy level, there have been studies which have suggested what can be done and what needs to be done to be taken forward. At the intervention, at the field level, there are other organizations, like, for instance, there is ActionAid, which works only with children who are in conditions of distress, trying to bridge the education that they don't get in a formal system. The government health program, for instance, does these specific initiatives with children of migrant groups, just to ensure that for something like for a universal immunization drive like polio, or, you know, any other immunization which they're supposed to get through the public health system, these children don't, you know, slip through the bracket. But what we are really missing is those children who are hidden. And when I mean those children who are hidden, those who are involved in something that's illegal, so it's not going to show up. Even migrant laborers, for to some extent, we can track and track them. But if you look at children who are in sex work or who are being exploited, the numbers are quite large. And from my, you know, work experience in HIV/AIDS, we've heard how often that you know, people usually look for girls, or, you know, for to have sex with a virgin. And there was this you know, kind of superstition that you get cured of HIV. So you're looking at people, girls as young as 12, 13 years who are trafficked into sex trade just because there's a market. Again, the earlier question spoke about the market. I mean, as long as there's a market, as long as there's somebody who's going to pay money for a child to be exploited, then there's always going to be a seller. People are going to be found. Either they're going to be found by force, or they're going to be, you know, found by some illegal means, but they're going to get there. So the key, I really think, is to just nipping the trade in the bud, which is to stop people from actually buying, you know, these children, stop this actual trafficking. The minute you stop buying, people are not going to sell. It's an ideal situation, but that's really what the government needs to be focusing on.